That was Steve, the hot dog vendor from Yankee Stadium. Things are going all right up there, Steve?
Great. Yeah. Going good.
All right. That's good. Nice shot of his ass. That's great. All right. He keeps bending over right on cue. All right, my next guest won the Miss America Petite competition back in 1994, which is just like winning the Miss America contest, except that the crown is actually much, much smaller. She's in a brand new movie called Chasing Papi. Say hi to Roslyn Sanchez. Sí, impressed with my Spanish?
Me gusta
también, y tú.
Gracias.
Yeah, that's all I got. Sí, Puerto Rico.
Colombia también.
Yeah, is that it? It's just Puerto Rico, Colombia, just everything, it all works.
It all works, yeah. Latino.
Yeah, there's a lot of Latino love going on. Thanks, buddy. He's drunk on Yankee dogs, apparently. Tell me a little bit about yourself, because I know when you were in Puerto Rico, you were already like a huge star there. You'd been on the number one TV show for 3 years. You'd won some pageants. Did you always just want to come here to the States?
And... Yeah, I think so. You know, I've been performing since I'm like 4 years old, so I knew I was going to leave at some point. And then I was 19 to 21 doing the TV show, and at 21 I decided that I wanted to go to New York, to come here, to study acting and learn English because it was really bad. And then started acting and singing, and to this day.
Were you studying English when you were there in preparation for coming to New York?
You know what, in Puerto Rico, it's interesting because you take English classes.
You said Puerto Rico so fast, it's unbelievable.
Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Puerto Rico, yeah. You take English classes, but the thing is that you talk in Spanish all the time. So even though you take like grammar, like I can write it very well.
Right.
But I don't remember ever in 21 years having a conversation in English. So when I moved to New York, I was able to understand, but I was like, I wouldn't speak.
Right, and when you moved to New York, how difficult was it? There's a large Puerto Rican contingency here. Did that make it easier for you?
You know, it was easy because I felt like I was in Puerto Rico. You know, there's so many Puerto Ricans. But at the same time, it's really interesting. Here in the States, if you say that you're Puerto Rican from New York, it's really like, oh, you're like, it's just weird. That in California, if you're Puerto Rican, it's like, oh, you're so exotic. Right. Is that an island? You know what I mean? Here is a different thing, but...
Why? It's not exotic here? What?
I guess not.
Is it like a slam if you say you're from Puerto Rico and you live in New York?
What do you mean slam?
Huh?
What do you mean slam?
Like, is it negative?
I don't know. No, I don't want to say that.
Yeah?
No, it's just different.
When you moved here to the States, you're a big star. Did you have to get a real job before you started to audition for roles and to get into acting?
No, I was doing well and because I came here with my savings. And I wasn't really smart spending the money. So I think after 8 months, I went through all my money. So that was the first time that I had to go get a real
job.
Normal job at a restaurant.
And what'd you do?
I went to a restaurant called Patria on 20th and Park Avenue South.
Right, yeah.
It's like a Latino restaurant. It's amazing food. And I used to go there all the time just as a customer. And I will always say to my friends, if I ever have to work at a restaurant, which is never going to happen, it's going to be here. But please, never. You know what I mean?
How did you blow your money, may I ask? What kind of stuff did you buy when you got here?
Because I was, when I came here, my mom said the only way you're going to go is if you go move with my second cousin, Kuka, at the Bronx.
You have a second cousin, Kuka, too? What are the odds of that?
So it was like kind of far.
Yeah.
So, and I refused to take a subway because I didn't even know what a subway was.
Right.
And I thought it was very dangerous. So I would just take taxis like back and forth. And
you
I would
blew your savings on New York cabs?
Not only that, like a lot of stuff, like would just go crazy. I would like go to expensive, I just thought that I was rich and I wasn't.
Right. So you worked at this restaurant and I know this is an authentic restaurant. So did you have people come there? Did anybody recognize you from back home?
Yeah.
Yeah? And would that freak them out? I mean, that'd be like going to Austria on a trip and you're at a car wash and there's Arnold Schwarzenegger, you know, cleaning your rims.
It was really, you know,
would they freak out?
Yeah, it was.
Work with me.
It was hard.
Yeah.
It was hard because when I left Puerto Rico, because I was doing so well over there, I thought that I was going to move to America and I was going to make it, like, within a year, I was going to be Salma Hayek. Like, it's going to take me 7 months to be huge. And, no.
Right.
It took me a lot of time. And still, I'm still trying. And I will be, because a lot of Latino people that come to New York, they go there because it's like a 4 or 5 star restaurant.
Right.
And now I'm the host. I wasn't a waitress, I was a host. So people will walk in and they will go, "Ay, mija, tú no eres Roslyn Sanchez."
Yeah.
Oh,
and like,
it
you know.
Hell. No, the thing is that their rent is very expensive over here. But
you have to explain to them why you're doing this menial job.
I was very young, you know what I mean? It was really hard and I would go to the bathroom and cry, but then I'd laugh now, but it was really.
How are you on money now? Are you okay?
I'm good.
Yeah, okay. And you got it's the big break with Rush Hour 2. It's Brett Ratner's film.
Yeah.
And he had a problem with the way that you look before casting you. I can't imagine. What did he think was wrong with you physically?
My hair was very long. I tested with my hair. I used to have very long hair. And I play an FBI agent, so he didn't think it was very professional to have my hair so long.
And what did he? Who did he want you to look like, or was there?
Meg Ryan. That's the picture they said. He wants you to look like this. That's the haircut.
Right. So did you go and get your hair cut?
No. No. I said, are you crazy? No. So I was like, please don't do that. I don't have that face. I don't have that hair. My hair is curly. You're going to destroy me. Don't do that. Please, please. So we did it all like, yeah.
Right. And then you got it. Good for you.
And then I got it.
I'm chasing Papi. What? Tell me what this is about. And what is Papi is like something you refer to as like your boyfriend and your father. It's always weird to hear people say, "Hi, Papi." Like,
you know,
I don't know if it's a term of endearment or like,
yeah,
or for your father. Or
a lot of things. Like I call my father Papi,
yeah.
Right? But I do call like guys Papi. It's just something. In Puerto Rico, it means like it's something cute. It's like saying, "Baby,
right.
Hey, baby."
Okay,
it's
hey,
like,
baby.
Papi.
So what is Chasing Papi about?
Chasing Papi is about it's a romantic comedy. It's three girls madly in love with this guy that is a papi chulo, a very very good looking Latino man.
Right.
And
Papi chulo.
The papi chulo.
Right.
Then he's
Sounds
dating
like
the three of
dinner.
Us. No, that's horrible. So he's dating the three of us at the same time. We decide to go visit him, and we meet each other every single time. Then we realize he's
so
cheating.
There's the papi chulo, and he's going out with you and two other women at the same time, and you don't know about each other.
Exactly.
Does this kind of thing actually go down in Puerto Rico?
It happens all over the world.
It does?
Of course.
And what do you play? Do you find out? Are you the one of the women
that
gets pissed
off? I'm the lawyer.
Off?
I'm the very conservative, very like serious, neurotic. I love poetry and type of girl.
Right.
And then, yeah, I go ballistic. I'm not very happy about it.
Okay. Do you know the clip we're about to show?
I think they told me it's the one that we are. We meet the girls. We go. We're like competing for his love.
Right.
We get together and then we make a toast.
See.
Something like that.
Okay, that's fine. Let's take a look at Chasing Papi. Here's Roslyn Sanchez. Take a look.
Too bad Tomas is gonna choose me over my dead body. Any way you like it.
Please. Please. We're stuck here together for the night. Soon Tomas is gonna wake up and he's gonna make his choice. The one he really loves.
The one that makes his heart bound in his chest. The one that he cannot stop thinking about.
A toast. To me.
Chasing Papi. That looked good. Is that a heavy Latin cast and crew, or was it more of an American film?
It's 90%, the cast is 90% Latin, but it's the first time that a big studio, Fox 2000, finances a Latino project.
It's crazy, because there's so much talk about this, like Latino music right now, even in like alternative and rock, and there's these huge groups, and they say that we're just almost like what hip hop was in the late 80s, how before it became mainstream. Do you feel that way? With the business for Latinos,
I think that doors are opening more and more for Latinos, whether it's music or film or TV. It's amazing. Of course, I believe that there's more doors to open. You know what I mean? We have a long way to go, but we're very grateful that they're giving us opportunity.
It seems crazy that it's not just now like a big time movie studio would back like a 95%.
It's really sad.
It's 2003. It seems like that would happen.
I think because they needed to see people like Jennifer Lopez and Salman, Benicio, Marc Anthony, Ricky Martin doing so well for them to believe.
Right.
That we can open a movie number one and we can have a record number one.
It's crazy to think that Ricky Martin's gonna be part of like the forefathers that paved the way for Latino people.
It's
no, it is wonderful. It just seems weird though,
I'm
just
very
a little
proud
bit,
of him,
you know.
Yeah. But you know what? He's a great performer. He's a talented kid. So
do you call him Papi? Do you see him?
I don't see him a lot, but I will definitely call him Papi when I see him. I actually think he's the real Papi Chulo for Latino.
Yeah? I like Marc Anthony. That guy's awesome.
He's
is the cover of Latina magazine. We get a shot of that right here. This is you on the cover. This is interesting, though, because the article on here is Roslyn Sanchez on the art of being hot.
I didn't know that was going to be the name of it.
And then that's the article.
When I saw it last week, I was like, what?
Does that piss you off? Like right here, it says the art of being hot.
Uh-huh.
And it says you can already hear the whispers, the next Jennifer, the next Salma. Does that bother you when they do stuff like that? Why can't you just be Roslyn Sanchez?
I know, you tell them, please.
Does that piss you off at all?
You know, I think at some point it's going to. Right now, I'm a huge fan of Jennifer and I'm a huge fan of Salma. So I'm looking at it as something positive, that they're even thinking that I can be that. But of course, at some point, then I would love for people to say she's just Roslyn Sanchez.
What the wrong man, that always happens to us. I think it's a pattern in the personal lives of many ambitious, talented women. I hope to find the right person in the future, but I do confess that I have tendencies to go toward the wrong man. Why?
I said that.
Yeah, why? Yeah, that's you. That's your quote.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know why I do that. I just, I don't, we like that, we like that. We always look at the, I don't know why I do that. I'm trying to change.
Yeah, well, you're doing a good job. We appreciate you stopping by here. Chasing Papi is in theaters now. And, oh, you have a record coming out too.
Yes.
All right, how's that? Is that done?
It's done, yeah, just finished.
Okay, we're is it in English?
The whole thing. In Spanish.
It's in Spanish?
Yeah, it's in Spanish. I signed with BMG Latin. I'm super, I've been, when I came to the States, I thought I was going to sing before I was going to act. That was like my main dream. And I started acting and kept acting, and now finally I said, I'm not getting any younger, so I have to do it soon. So I'm doing it now, and I'm very excited. I think it's going to be hot, hot and sexy.
It's funny because when an American talent acts and sings and tries to do multiple things, they end up being sort of scrutinized for that. It doesn't kind of work. It's a little cheesy. Mm. But with people like yourself or Jennifer Lopez, yeah, or maybe even Latinos in general, it seems to be very cool and it works. Do you get that sense at all?
I don't know. I think Jennifer is the only one. No, you know I'm lying because Mark Anthony does movies too. I don't know what it is. Maybe it is because Latinos, we're very passionate and we love dancing. Since, I mean, it comes, it's in our genes, you know, right, in our blood. You know, like for, there's a lot of Latinos, especially in Puerto Rico, girls go to dance classes and piano and singing since they're very, very young. So I just think it's something that we have.
All right, good. Great to have you here, sweetheart.
Thank
nice
you so
to
much.
Meet you as well.
Thank
Roslyn
you.
Sanchez, everybody. Be sure and check out Chasing Papi in theaters. And check out the record. It's coming out in July. We'll be right back with a little comedy, thank God.